As at now, I cannot give you the exact cause of the fire, but it happened during the daytime, and there was a loud explosion that was heard from the pipeline, and that from the eyewitnesses, nobody can tell you that whether it is a pipeline vandalization or not, but all that we had is loud explosion and vibration. You can see the vibration affected a lot of houses here. So that's all I can tell you for now.
After this, our rescue mission, we can now sit down and see what really happened. Casualties, but it cannot be ascertained.
I was in my house, the washing cloth. I just heard something make boo, the whole sink, everybody was checking. Then we run downstairs to come and look what was happening. And getting there, people was calling us that there was a pipeline explosion in a trade fair area.
Yes.
Then when I reach, I get here, a lot of houses were destroyed, even the back market were destroyed. So people were arguing that it's not like, it's like bomb. The fire service, about 5 fire service lorry we are here, but they are doing nothing. Just pouring water on the plank.
I will see how the government to put more effort by equipping the fire servicemen. Because they are human beings too. They are less power what you can do when you don't have the equipment to fight well. You can imagine a hose that is not even up to 10 meters. They are using to fight a fire that is almost a mile to them. So it's not the firefighters' problem. So the government itself have to do a lot of things to make sure they equip people that are working for them. Right. That is very important. They have to know that. In other civilized countries, they use helicopters to take care of things like this.
I see tankers. I wouldn't say they don't have enough this thing, but I see their tankers. I think on ground here, yeah, they have more than, if it's not more than 10. And okay, they came. There are so many from everywhere, Solo, everywhere.
The Baloziness Association, under the leadership of Chief Anthony Obi, procure some firefighting equipment and have trained some workers against that. So if you go to the security office, you will see firefighting equipment there. Vehicles are there, the drivers are there, and the people who are trained for such, they are also there. So we don't press for such a thing will happen.
I got here exactly 30 minutes related to the explosion occurred, and that I was informed that it was a technical fault from the pipeline. It's not as a result of a vandal, and that there's a gas leakage before it caught fire. And because some army are around this place, that are monitoring the pipeline about 10, 20 meters away from the pipeline. So it's not a matter of human effort. It's a technical effort from the pipeline stuff. So that now that the neighboring houses, buildings, schools were affected. Some houses came down, and you can see the effect on some of the roof within the areas of the fire explosion. And some houses, like I said, came down. And neighboring schools around, particularly Bethlehem School, some pupils there had been trapped. But we were able to rescue through human effort. We were able to rescue some students out of the place, some are still there, and effort is ongoing. And we have made call to emergency agency people to come to our rescue, because this what is going on here is a collateral damage in the local government.